actually freestyle poetry too, like to even get into just the letting my ideas kind of go through. So so we keep that in mind, but obviously you guys have creative energy, creative potential. You know, you wouldn't have been able to do that if you didn't have some idea of way creating a line that's interesting to you. All right. Now, basically, it's just trying to match that rhythm aspect of it with the creation aspect of it, and then just getting the confidence up to actually do it on the spot. All right. So we're gonna do a very, very, I'm gonna say basic exercise because I saw you guys dance and you obviously have rhythm. All right. But we're gonna kind of get inside of it a little bit.
We do.
Some of us think we do. That's us.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm trying to be, politically correct. You all got rhythm, all right? Anyway, but we're gonna break it down a little bit because I think a lot of times, you know, I don't know what everybody, how much you're exposed to music, but you know, it's like you feel a beat, you just start dancing, but you don't know, like, you know, what a fourth beat is, a second beat is, a verse beat. You're just, you know, dancing, you know? Like a lot of times people be swaying like this, you know, every time you're hitting, every time you hear a snare hit, it's on the two and the four for the most part. It's like one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Like every time a snare usually hits, it's on the two and the four of a bar. Does that make sense? Yeah? Okay. All right, so we're just gonna play an instrumental. All right? And basically, I want you guys, we're basically gonna clap on the fourth beat of whatever instrument you decide to play. All right, we're gonna kind of get that going, okay?
Okay, me too.
All right. I'll tell you when to start. Harder for me than it is for you. But I'm going to say a word on the fourth beat.